truly Colorado experience is making a comeback.
We're so excited.
I'm away from home.
Iconic spots ready to rebound.
Honestly, it gives me chills. I think anybody who works in this business knows how hard it's been.
Restrictions are easing, but questions linger.
Who's going to want to go in a concert if they don't know everybody's been vaccinated?
And we could see a major shift on mask rules and capacity caps within 3 weeks.
We embrace the direction of local control.
Tonight, a look at what the rebound means for Colorado's biggest venues and the challenges they're working to overcome. Sports, concerts, family barbecues, Colorado is inching closer to a summer that could look pretty normal.
We're already seeing venues rebound with limited crowds attending games at Ball Arena. Tomorrow, more than 20,000 fans will flock to Coors Field for opening day.
And Governor Polis is signaling he's ready to hand over the reins on setting pandemic rules. Within a few weeks, decisions about mask wearing and capacity caps could be up to your city and county leaders. Good evening, everybody. Welcome to Denver 7 News at 10. I'm Shannon Ogden.
I'm Jessica Porter in for Andrew Heo. Thank you for joining us. For now, many venues are reopening with limited capacity.
And that creates a conundrum for places like Red Rocks. How do you convince artists to perform if ticket sales would just be a fraction of what they were before? Leading us off tonight, Denver 7's Liz Gilardi.
It's a very special place. It's a place that people fly in from all over the world to come see shows.
Last year, the music stopped. Images of wall-to-wall people at Red Rocks seemed like a distant memory.
It's not going to look like it did 2 years ago, but it's a good place to start.
Red Rocks will host concerts, but only 2,500 people will be allowed. It's less than 30% capacity, meaning bands will have to make a decision that's not only about the music.
I can assure one thing. A band will not be there if they're not going to be able to cover their own rent.
Rich Ross, a member of the Freddie Jones Band, knows what it's like to cancel shows. He played his last concert in February 2020, and many of his friends have been out of work for more than a year.
And by the time we had rebooked shows that were canceled, now some of those shows have been rebooked 3 or 4 times now at this point.
Rich says the current capacity restrictions could be a hard sell, and if a band is thinking about touring, they have to navigate varying restrictions from state to state.
The more we get 50-75%, I think that would be more manageable, but I don't see bands being able to cover their overhead travel.
Red Rock spokesman Brian Kitts says some bands are once again choosing to postpone to next year and others are canceling. But the thought of concert goers coming back.
Honestly, it gives me chills. We're glad to have anything at all at this point.
He realizes that might not be enough for some artists.
Some of those acts can play for $2,500 and feel fine about the money that they'll make. Some of them would rather wait until a venue is at full capacity. And I think we all understand that. You know, this is a business, whether it's the venue side or the artist side. And you know, COVID has done a number on everybody. And, you know, so those are individual decisions that artists are making.
Throughout the summer, we could see more fans allowed in. And isn't that what makes a concert so special? Being surrounded by hundreds of people enjoying the same music, singing along. Liz Gilardi, Denver 7.
It's going to be nice when it happens. So here's a question. What do you do if you have tickets for a sold out show that is happening under capacity restrictions? Well, that one Red Rocks is still trying to figure out. If your show is canceled, you will get a refund. If it is rescheduled, you're going to have the option to get a refund or hold on to that ticket for a later date.
Through the pandemic, Governor Jared Polis took the lead on setting pandemic rules.
And soon all that could change. You know, we're pretty familiar with Colorado's rainbow of COVID restrictions by now. Based on case numbers and vaccination rates, each county gets a different color and a different set of rules.
Now, as we rebound, Governor Polis says he's looking forward to handing over control to local leaders and letting them decide what rules best fit their needs. That means mask mandates and capacity caps could soon be set locally on or after April 16th.
Really, the only types of events that will remain under state guidance will be large-scale events, thousands of people together. Doesn't mean they can't occur. It just means that there need to be thoughtful health guidelines.
Polis says he'll still implement a statewide mask mandate for schools. He says a priority is to make sure in-person classes continue through the rest of the year with as few interruptions as possible.
Helping our state rebound depends on getting people vaccinated and keeping COVID case numbers low. And roughly 29% of Coloradans already received at least one dose of the vaccine. Now the Department of Corrections is offering a $500 bonus to staff who get the shot. The department says about 44% are vaccinated and it wants to boost that number. Staff with a medical or religious exemption are also eligible for the payment.
A new study suggests that our current vaccines will hold up well against variants of COVID-19. Researchers for the National Institute of Allergy and Infectious Diseases followed people who caught the disease and recovered. And they found that T cells, a key part of the immune response, stayed active. And that is such good news because those T cells are largely unaffected by the changes found in those new variants.
And there are encouraging signs that the Pfizer vaccine can protect kids, too. The drug maker says its trials show 100% effectiveness in kids aged 12 to 15. Researchers found zero COVID cases among the group of 1,000 vaccinated kids. Right now, the vaccine is authorized for people 16 and older. Pfizer plans to ask the FDA to expand that.
And the upcoming vacation season brings some obvious questions. So mom and dad may be fully inoculated by travel time, but what about families with the younger children who obviously won't be vaccinated? Can you still travel together? I put that question for you today to the chief medical officer of Rocky Mountain Hospital for Children. And if you already are planning that family vacation, I'm afraid you're not going to like the answer.
But what the CDC strongly suggests is that if it's elective travel, meaning travel that isn't totally necessary, they still recommend that it be postponed.
And Dr. Washington emphasizes that that recommendation could change at any time. A pediatric COVID vaccine is not expected until late this year or in 2022. Well, if you're looking for family-friendly fun closer to home, maybe you're planning to head to Coors Field for opening day tomorrow.
Denver 7's Russell Haythorne takes a 360 look at what it means to finally replace the cardboard cutouts with living, cheering fans.
Rockies baseball returns.
Go Rockies!
And for the first time since the 2019 season, fans will be in the stands. 46% capacity, 21,000 fans total.
For sports fans, yeah, it's time.
I know the fans, when they get back in here, it's going to be on. They're going to be super excited, super pumped.
But the boys of Blake Street will hit the diamond without one of their best players, the team trading away third baseman Nolan Arenado a few weeks ago.
We're the laughingstock of baseball. If 21,000 people give money to the Mumfords, that's sad because they don't deserve it. But the Rockies themselves, I love the Rockies.
So let's go 360 and explore the good, the bad, and the ugly on the return of Rockies baseball. We'll hear from the team and the owner, a sports columnist and blogger, a former Major League Baseball player, fans just like you. And we'll start in Lodo, where businesses like the Cherry Cricket Ballpark location,
sanitized tables, go Rockies,
are brimming with excitement.
Can't even sit still, I can't contain myself, just to see people in the area.
General Manager Samantha Taxon says they're ready.
We have our front patio, we'll have TVs out there by then.
Fans certainly share that excitement.
It's time to open up.
I'm excited. I'm ready to go to concerts. I'm ready to go to sporting events. I'm ready to get out and do.
For us, we're a sports family. When you took sports away and took fans away, it was just difficult, right?
But while they're optimistic about returning to the stands, fans do not share the same optimism about the Rockies' chances this season.
I didn't want to buy new Rockies gear because they don't deserve it. But purple runs in my blood. And I do it.
Fans like Benjamin Crane can't hide their seething resentment of owner Dick Monfort and GM Jeff Breidich for the recent trade of 8-time Gold Glove winner.
That is caught by Nolan.
Nolan Arenado.
Breidich needs to be fired for one. He's absolutely terrible. He's almost an idiot. I feel terrible like saying that, but absolutely as a fan, disgusting. I'm not happy about it at all.
That's a big loss.
Former major leaguer John Knott says Arenado did what he had to do.
It's just kind of part of the game. You go where they want you.
And that is what's so mind-boggling to blogger and columnist Ian St. Clair.
But when you look at Pat Bowlen, it's that commitment. You want to win, and you will do everything it takes to win. Dick Monfort and Charlie Monfort don't want to win. They don't care about winning. That has always bothered me. It's not about winning. It's about having something to pass on to his kids.
St. Clair is the site runner and lead writer for PlayColorado.com, where he promotes responsible sports betting.
There are two teams, when you look at the sports betting odds as of right now, that are worse than the Colorado Rockies in terms of World Series odds. That's the Pittsburgh Pirates and the Texas Rangers. The Rockies are just lost in the woods with no compass on how to get to a winning tradition.
Monfort has insisted it wasn't about the money, but rather Arenado wanting out.
I'm aware this is not a popular decision, but I promise you it wasn't made with haste.
Human beings change over time.
But there was a well-reported, long-running rift between Arenado and Breidich.
The relationship wasn't always peaches and cream.
As for the players and manager Bud Black, they're now left to navigate all the doom and gloom predictions while starting the season with a bit of a chip on their shoulders.
Plain and simple, overall goal for myself and the team is win. There's nothing I'm setting my sights on. I just want to go out there, win, and then prove doubters wrong.
Despite the fact that the Rockies are a long shot, there is little doubt fans will fill every seat available, at least to start the season.
So much has gone on over the last year. It's going to be a hot ticket just to see the Rockies.
They're just so happy to be out.
Just to get out, to be amongst others, to drink a beer while watching the Rockies.
In Lodo, Russell Haythorne, Denver 7.
Drop pass shot, score!
The Avs riding high on those cheers of support from the home crowd tonight. It's their first game in front of a crowd at Ball Arena this season. They invited first responders, healthcare staff, and frontline workers to watch the game. Coming up, Denver 7 sports director Lionel Bienvenu has full coverage of this unbelievable game.
Some days I'm not good at all because it doesn't seem real.
Grieving the loss of someone who brought joy to everyone around her.
Well, she made a happy life for herself, even with her disabilities.
More than a week after the attack in Boulder, we're hearing more about Terry Liker and her three decades of loyal service at King Soopers.
How the grocery chain now plans to honor her legacy.
Looks like beautiful weather for the Rockies home opener, and the weekend forecast gets even better.